In this video, we're going to take a look at a common application that we see a lot of times when we study systems of equations. This particular application is dealing with money or interest that we've earned in a bank account, where we actually have not just one account, but two separate accounts where we're taking our money and divvying it up, some into one account and some more into another account, usually that earn different levels of interest. So you'll notice that all of these problems, if you have 10 of these in your textbook, they might have different names for the people, and they might call it a bank account, and one might call it a mutual fund, but the underlying process is identical for all of these problems just about. All right, so here's an example that we're going to work through. It says Katie invested $3,000 in two different bank accounts for 1 year. One of the accounts paid 13% annual interest, and the other paid 5% annual interest. Now, they don't tell us how much she put in account A and in account B. We just know that together it was $3,000. It says if Katie earns $330 interest during the first year from both of the accounts together, how much did she invest in each of the accounts separately? It's a good question. So right now, initially, it seems darn near impossible to figure out how much she put in each account, but it's actually quite simple if we set it up as a system of equations. So a little bit of background that we need to know going into this problem is how you compute interest. You might already know this, but the formula for interest is the interest earned in a particular bank account is the principal, which is the amount that you're investing in that account, times the interest rate, times how long you left it in that bank account. Now, for our examples, the vast majority of these, the time unit will just be 1 year. So normally we don't even have a time unit for us. Usually it's just going to be P times R, because as it said, it was just for 1 year. All right, the principal is how much we're investing, and the interest rate, the R value, needs to be a decimal. I need to mention that as well. So instead of 13%, we would need to say 0.13 in our math. So let's move on to how we would actually solve this guy. I would highly recommend making a table. Tables are very, very helpful when you do these types of problems. We're going to make a row for each account, and we're going to have all the information needed: the principal, the rate, the time, and the interest that you're getting from each of these accounts. So let's go through and jot down what we know. All right, so in account A, in the first account, the amount that you put just in account A, it's not $3,000, it's less than that. In fact, I don't really know. I don't know how much we put in account A, so I'm gonna put X. The interest rate for account A will be 0.13. The time is 1 year. So the interest that Katie made from account A would be the principal times the rate times the time, so 0.13x, right? Looks good. All right, now the amount in account B, I don't know that either, so I'm going to call that Y. Now, if you're used to calling it something else, maybe like 3,000 minus X, if you've done this in another math class, hold on to that thought. We'll come back to that in a minute. But for now, I'm just going to call this Y. Okay, so I've got another amount in account B that I don't know how much that is either. The interest rate there is 0.05, again for 1 year. And the interest would be 0.05 of Y. All right, now what can we do with this? What do we know? Well, we know some things from, you know, from the exercise here. We know that she invested $3,000 total. Well, what would equal 3,000? Well, I think it would be how much she put in account A plus the amount she put in account B. So from that, I think we can write X plus Y has to equal 3,000, right? And then we also know that she earned a total of $330. Now, in interest. So I think that would be the same as taking the interest from account A and adding it to the interest in account B. So we could say 0.13x plus 0.05y equals $330. And what we have right here is a system. That's a system of equations that we've been studying over the last few videos. So if you can solve the system for X and Y, we will know how much she invested in each account. Right, now, if you've studied the same type of interest problem in another math class, another approach that you might have taken, just to go ahead and clear this up, if you invest X dollars in account A, then it's not just an arbitrary amount for Y. Why? Because the two amounts have to add up to $3,000. So you could have written this as 3,000 minus whatever was in account A. So if you invested $1,000 in account A, it would have to be $2,000 in account B. But the only problem with taking that approach is you wouldn't see that in this math class, because that wouldn't be a system anymore, because you wouldn't have X's and Y's, you just have X's. So even though that's a totally valid approach, if you're doing this in the chapter that you're studying on systems, this is how you need to do it, where you would set up an equation for the principal adding up to 3,000 and the interest adding to 330. All right, now, how do we solve the system? Totally your choice. You can use the graphing method, which I wouldn't recommend. That's not really a great method for this particular problem. Substitution method, that would work awesome. Or the addition method or elimination method, that would work awesome. Totally your choice. Personally, I think I will do... I'll do substitution method, okay? I've got a coefficient of 1 for the X and the Y. That sounds easiest to me. All right, so we'll come over here. We'll solve for one variable in terms of the other. So let's just solve for Y. So Y would be 3,000 minus X. That's what I was referencing earlier. You could have had that instead of Y. And then now that you know what Y is equal to, you can go ahead and take that quantity and plug it in for Y in the other equation. So you'd have 0.13X. And actually, I think I'll do this on a new page, just so I have room to work. 0.13X plus 0.05Y, but Y, as you know, was 3,000 minus X. And that would equal $330. 0.13x plus 0.05y equals 330, but I subbed out the y right here. This is great. This is an equation with only one variable, should be easier to solve. So we'd have 0.13x plus, and then we'll distribute this particular guy right here. So let's see, we would have, 1,550, I believe, if my math's right, minus 0.05x equals 330, 0.05x, all right, still a linear equation, let's combine like terms. 0.13x minus 0.5x would be 0.08x equals, subtract 150 to the other side, we'd have 180, divide both sides by 0.8, and you would get, oh, let's see here, get a calculator. And actually that should be 0.8. I just noticed my typo, sorry about that. 0.08, let's be careful with that. Be $2,250, $2,250. But now remember, that was just account A, that was the X value. This is account A. And we also need the amount in account B as well, that was the Y value. So to get the Y value, you can use any old equation. I think I'll use the one where we had Y was equal to 3,000 minus X. So if your X is 2250, then your Y value would be $750. So perfect. So if you invest $2,250 in the account that pays 13%, and $750 of the $3,000 in the account that pays 5%, together, the interest that each one would earn would add up to a total of $330. So again, this is a great exercise where you're using systems of equations to do something interesting. So you take your word problem, you set it up as a system, which is what we did here. You set it up as a system, and then you solve your system to get your answer.